Probably a meteor, isn't it?
That's what it is.
Dad, don't go out there.
You stay in there.
Please, Dad, don't
get
go
out there. Is the telephone still on? Call the police.
They'll take care of you.
Okay, George, let's have a look at you.
Oh, don't you start fussing too. I've got singed, that's all.
It's still too hot to put water on. They could do with another pump.
It should be heavily green now.
What's all this about, Dick?
Could be practically anything.
The
object was first sighted at about 9:15 this evening, and its approach was widely observed over the southern counties. A statement just issued by the Home Office stresses that there is no general danger. Members of the public, however, are warned to stay away from the area. I will repeat that.
The Home Office stresses that there's no immediate danger. Do you realize what you'll have to face if this turns out to be a disaster, Quatermass?
How much further?
150 miles. I'm talking to you.
For the last 20 miles, I've been painfully aware of that.
Well, then answer, man. How did it happen? What went wrong?
For the first time in the history of the world, man has sent a rocket 1,500 miles into space. You can't expect such an experiment to be perfect.
Well, you must have had some idea.
I'm a scientist, not a fortune teller who predicts what will happen.
Well, you had instruments, radio contact.
We lost it for over 57 hours, sir. Broke loose, and we don't even know how far it's been. Had no further contact even when it returned to the orbit.
Yet you brought it down by your own control.
Well, that's something to tell your ministry. Quatermass set it up and he brought it back.
Please, oh, please.
Couldn't you pick some other time for this?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Croon.
I happen to be concerned with the Ministry of Defense.
And I'm not a civil servant. I'm a doctor. And I happen to be concerned with three men. The three men who are in that rocket.
Oakley Green. This is it.
Certainly no secret.
Sorry, no one allowed past this point.
All right, the Ministry of Defense.
Oh, yes, sir. All right, there, open it up.
Sorry, miss, you must keep back. Oi, miss! Hey, just a minute, please! Miss!
Aye, aye, chasing the girls again.
Aye, you think it was a bank holiday the way they come flocking out?
I'd like a flock home.
You stay put, my lad, till that thing cools off.
Or blows up.
Now, don't start that story going around. They've said it's not a bomb.
But why can't we put water on it?
Listen, Charlie, we've had instructions. Yeah, don't ask me why, because they didn't tell us. Hey! Hey, just a minute!
Mr. Blake, Ministry of Defense!
I'll get the inspector.
Try and get through a little,
Marsh. What's up?
Give me a temperature reading. Why don't you go and wait in the car, Judith?
It's funny. It looks exactly the same. Yet it's been... who knows how far. There isn't a word.
Hello, Q1, hello. Q1, Q1. This is Marsh. Hello, Caroon, Green, Reichenheim. You receive me, over.
Keep trying.
Mr. Blake?
I'm Quatermass. I'll be in charge from here on, Inspector.
Can't say I'm sorry about that. What's the next move?
We can't do anything right now. Not until that cools off.
How long will that be, sir?
I would say 3 or 4 hours at least.
Q1. This is Marsh. Do you hear me? Do you hear me?
Over. We've been there for 4 hours.
I suppose you'd like me to open it up right now, huh? One blast of air in against that heat would incinerate them.
Some reporters here from London, sir. They'd like some facts.
They'll get some later.
They'll get some now. Bring them on, Major.
Don't you think we ought to find out a few more ourselves first?
Bring them on, Major.
Are you hearing me, Q1? Are you hearing me? This is Marsh calling Q1. Q1, over.
You know, if I ever gave them all the facts, you'd find one or two of them difficult to explain.
Don't try and drag me through the mud, Blake. You might splash a little bit on yourself, you and your committee.
You deliberately launched that rocket without waiting for official sanction.
If the whole world waited for official sanction, it'd be standing still. You took too long. I made my own decision.
To gamble with three men's lives.
Every experiment is a gamble. The unknown is always a risk. They should know that.
Did she know that? That woman over there waiting, hoping and praying?
It's dropped another 100 degrees since we arrived.
Still got a long way to go.
Let's hope that insulation lining doesn't crack out.
Yes, let's hope it didn't. Because if it did, Quatermass, and those three men in there are
dead or alive, they'll be heroes.
Are you all right?
Let me tell you something, Blake. They'll fire the imagination so that there'll be 100 men begging for the same privilege when we launch the second rocket. You can't stop it now.
Do you receive me?
You mean I can't stop you now?
That's right.
This is Marsh calling Q1. Marsh calling Q1. Do you hear me? Do you hear me? Over.
There's nothing, sir.
Nothing, Quatermass. You know what you've done.
I launched it and I brought it back. That's quite an achievement, I think.
And those three men...
What? Were... What is it, Marsh?
Something came through.
Pull up. Volume, pull up. It's a tapping. Coming from inside.
By the hull, near the transmitter.
Q1, Q1. Green, Reichenheim, Caroon. This is Quatermass, Quatermass. We can hear you. Can you hear us? Over. Q1, can you hear me? You've landed in England. We're here, not 50 yards from you. Are you all right? Over. Tapping has stopped. We can't wait. We've got to get him out of there now. Bring me the fire chief.
Right away, sir.
Set the remote control.
Are you mad? You know what'll happen if we open that rocket door now.
We've got to take that risk. We know one of them is alive in there. In an hour, he may not be.
But you said that would incinerate them. You can't do a thing
like
that.
Don't tell me what I can do and what I can't do.
Listen, that shell temperature is still 300 degrees.
All right. What would you suggest? Wait till it's absolutely safe and then bring them out? Dead?
Door control set, sir.
Hold it. Where's that fire chief?
Get an ambulance moved in. Stand by.
Ambulance. You want me, sir?
Yes. Round up every man and piece of machinery you've got. Move it in there as close as possible. We're going to open the rocket door from here by remote control. When the door opens, when I give you the signal, I want every hose turned full force around that entrance. Now, you got it?
Well, that thing's still as hot as the bases. I don't know. You start pumping water.
Don't argue with me. I know what I'm doing.
I hope so, sir.
Major.
Sir.
I want this whole field cleared. When they come out of the rocket, I want absolutely no one on the field. You understand? No one.
Don't worry, sir.
In there. We don't know what condition they'll be in, so you better get everything out. Oxygen, morphine,
glucose. Well, now it's up to you.
Keep your eye on me. I'll give you the signal. All set?
Set, sir.
Start it up. Let me know when you're minus 10 to pressure.
Right, sir. Minus 10... 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Not been opened. Now.
you trying to tell me?
I'm not trying to tell you anything. Let the camera do that.
I'm afraid the camera won't tell us anything.
Are they all right?
Something happened. They're not there. Victor, where's Green? Where's Reichenheim? What happened?
Please, not now.
Wait a minute.
He's in no condition to talk. He's in too severe a state of shock. He must be treated.
He's got to talk first. He's got to tell me what happened.
Gordon. What is it, Victor? What is it?
He said, help me. That's all he said. Help me.
So it doesn't make me any prettier, but I got a lunch date with the wife.
Any special reason?
Uh-huh. Her favorite day of the month. Payday. Oh, a big man on payday.
Yes, sir.
See the papers?
Quatermass.
You're stirring it up with the police. How dare we take fingerprints from a sick man?
There's nothing else I could do. He couldn't talk, couldn't answer any questions. Thought we might as well get his prints. You never know.
No, you never know.
He's a weird one, all right.
Skin, it's just like shaking hands with a piece of ice.
Sergeant, there's no way to talk about a public hero.
Come in. Mr. Quatermass, I see you, sir.
Well, speaking of public heroes, all right, wheel him in.
Yes, sir.
Quatermass, eh? This is what's known as penetrating into enemy territory.
Inspector Lomax?
I'm Lomax. This is Sergeant Best. Won't you sit down?
I'll come direct to the point, Inspector. I will not have your men coming into my research center and treating Victor Caroon as though you're a pathological criminal.
Well, nobody
He's a sick man, Inspector. He's been through an ordeal that very few men could survive.
Two men didn't survive it, did they, Mr. Quatermass?
What exactly do you mean by that?
I wish you'd sit down. If I sit and you stand, I'm being rude, and I'm longing to sit down. You see, Mr. Quatermass, I'm an old-fashioned sort of chap. I don't know much about rockets or traveling in space. I don't read science fiction. I'm a plain, simple Bible man. I have a routine mind and I have to do routine things.
Such as fingerprinting an unconscious man?
When three men take off in a rocket and only one comes back, in our reckoning, that leaves minus two. And minus two puts us in the embarrassing position of having to investigate plus one. Whether he's conscious, unconscious, or a gibbering idiot.
Fine. I think I can save you a lot of time, Inspector, with your so-called investigation. I have here the particulars on all three members of the crew. Charles Green, Ludwig Reichenheim, Victor Caroon. You'll find everything there, Inspector. Medical histories, personal description, academic achievements, professional activities, politics, and even fingerprints.
Well, that's very thoughtful of you.
There's only one investigation likely to serve any good purpose in this situation, Inspector. That's a scientific one. I'm sure even you will agree that between us, I'm the best qualified for that assignment. Good day, Inspector. Sergeant.
Well, they might almost say we'd been given a rocket.
Yes, sir.
It's absolutely unbelievable. It just isn't clinically possible that his heart should respond like this. Pulse, blood pressure, the same. Impossibly low. He shouldn't be alive, but he is.
Can't you do something to increase the metabolic rate?
Tried everything. No effect.
I never knew pressure effects to last this long.
Well, these aren't just pressure effects. It isn't only his face. Take a look at his skin. Anyway, here, on the shoulder. Feel it.
Swollen. Coarsened.
Yes, and that's not all, either. Look at the contour of the face.
You mean the bone structure?
Yes, I could be wrong about a limb, but not about the shape of the bones. There's been a change. I'm convinced of that.
Is he any better?
He's coming along fine.
If only he'd say something. Give us a sign that he's thinking, that he knows we're here.
He knows, Judith. He knows we're trying to help him.
What is happening to him?
Well, that's what we're trying to find out.
Shouldn't he be in a hospital?
That's exactly where he should be.
Briscoe.
I can't take this responsibility any longer. I haven't got the proper equipment here to do the right tests. He belongs in a hospital.
I suppose you're right. I suppose you're both right. He does belong in a hospital. But can a hospital do more than you can do? Would a hospital know what goes on out there in space, on the other side of the air? There's a whole new world out there, a wilderness, uncharted. And he's been there and come back. He's got the map. Unlock his mind for me, Briscoe, and find it. I know you can do it.
It isn't just a question
of... I know the strain and tension you've been under, but to stop now when we're so close, on the brink of something tremendous, the very fringe of some great discovery, we can't stop now, Briscoe. Besides, it's our only chance to learn what happened to the others.
At a hospital, you'd have all the most modern...
Would a hospital know how to deal with a man who's been exposed to rocket radiation?
In his bloodstream, there was absolutely...
Or the effects of pressure at 1,500 miles up.
During flight training, he took seven times the force of gravity without even a headache to show
for. We know that. But would a hospital know it?
I'll try another transfusion, see if that'll help.
Thanks. You'll stay with him, won't you, Judy? He needs you.
Victor.
I think we'll move him into the office. We can make him more comfortable in there. Would you help me, please?
Of course. Thank you for all you're doing, Gordon.
I only wish I could do more.
The solution is elementary, my dear Inspector. Victor Caron killed the two men, removed their pressure suits, pushed their bodies out into space, and then linked the suits together again. Now, what do you want?
Two things. Number one, I want to return these files. Green, Reichenheim, Caron. Very interesting. Caron.
Number two?
Well, I want you to give me your solemn word...
Well, Inspector, I'm a very busy man.
Now, look, sir, nobody ever wins a Cold War. One of us had better come over to the other side. If you don't want to come over to mine, I'm not proud, I'll come over to yours.
Solemn word about what?
That these were Caron's fingerprints.
Of course they were. Everybody in Research Center gets fingerprinted. What are you getting at?
To be quite honest, I don't quite know, sir.
Nothing unusual about these.
These are the fingerprints we took off Caron last night.
What about them?
Compare them.
Is this a joke?
This is no joke, sir. The man who took those had his training in the fingerprint section. It's second nature to him.
But these prints aren't even... human. Yes? Yes. You found what? I'll be right there.
Well, wherever you're going, I might as well keep you company, mightn't I? Thank you. It's very nice of you.
Was when I was checking the safety casing on the wiring. Behind there.
Can you get at it?
No.
It's right in the crevice. Hand me the sample spoon from my box.
More of this?
Yes, sir, lots. On the left, by the rivet there.
Mind if I have a sample for our people?
Sure, we'll give you a sample. Frisco, what do you think it is?
I don't think. I want to be sure.
I've been in this thing all night. I smell that stuff's been around the whole time.
Out of that lamp. You got the same bright thoughts that I have?
Something happened in here. Something beyond our understanding at the moment. If I only knew where to begin.
Maybe the film will help.
Film?
Yes, the lab should have developed it by now.
I thought you told me the camera was smashed.
It was badly damaged, but I managed to get the film out.
Why didn't you tell me?
Well, the lab said they didn't know if they could develop it or not.
They've got to develop it. You get right down to that laboratory and tell them they've got to develop that film.
Yes, sir.
And I'll have no delays or excuses. Tell them to get the best process man in the country. Tell them to get anybody they want, but I've got to have that film.
Right, sir.
This is one premiere I don't want to miss.
Harmless, it's organic, it's jelly. End of analysis.
No definite identification?
Well, it might conceivably represent the dead remnants of cell tissue.
What sort of cell tissue?
Could be animal, could be human.
Human?
Could be.
Do you know what you're saying?
I know what I'm thinking.
Are you sure it's not some sort of plant cell?
Positive.
You mean to say that... You're asking me to believe that that is the remains of two human beings?
I'm not asking you to believe anything. You asked a question, I answered it.
Does she know?
No, this is the first sleep she's had in nights.
What about the police analysts? What do they say?
No report through yet. But I don't doubt it'll be the same.
It's almost beyond human understanding. Some fantastic, invisible force converted two men into jelly. Is that the slide?
That's the slide. I'm about to call it a day, Quatermass. Beyond this, I'm a babe in a...
Gordon!
All right, get him up. No, wait a minute. His hand. Another change. Get him back to bed. Look what's happening to his skin. In just the last few moments, I'll go and get him a sedative.
You've done this to him. He'd have been better off if he'd been killed or stayed out there.
Judith!
You've destroyed him like you've destroyed everything else you've touched.
Destroyed him? I've brought him back. I've saved him.
Saved him for what? For further experiments? I can help him more than you or anyone else can.
There's no room for personal feelings in science, Judith. Some of us have a mission. You should be very proud to have a husband who's willing to risk his life for the betterment of the whole world.
What world? Your world? The world of Quatermass.
I've sent for an ambulance. He's going to the central clinic.
All right, Briscoe.
send him to the clinic. But I want him to have complete isolation, you understand? Complete isolation. No one is to see him. No one. Until I say so.
We've tried three different grades of stock, developed each one to as high a gamma as possible, and still it's made no difference. Look at this. It's grainy and dull.
All I want is a print.
Well, we don't like any print that isn't up to standard.
Is there a picture on it?
Oh, there's a picture, all right, but you can see how dull and grainy.
I don't care how dull and grainy it is. I must have this now.
It could be altitude, or an extreme change of temperature, or penetration of cosmic rays.
Fine, fine, I'll tell him that.
Well, I don't know what the old man will say.
Listen, you tell your old man that our old man said if he didn't get this print, he'd dynamite the building.
I can't tell the ministry this. They'll think I've lost my senses.
That's exactly why you must tell them nothing. Now you see why I must have absolute authority to isolate Karun.
But every newspaper in town has got a story on him being admitted into the clinic. They'll want to know why, and what's happened to him, and what's happened to the others.
All right, do you want to tell them?
Well, not telling them won't stop the panic.
What they don't know won't start a panic.
Inspector, what about the police analysis?
The same, Mr. Blake.
Well, what's the next move?
Well, we've agreed to isolation. It's the only thing we can do until we know more.
Yeah? The film's ready.
See that, Marsh? It works.
Yes, sir.
What worked? Automatic prism. It cuts in the panel readings.
Is that all?
Once in the observation zone, the camera's geared to cut out at regular intervals.
This will be the 0.16 period.
That must be where we lost them.
What on earth could have happened?
Look at that fantastic temperature drop.
Thank you.
Run it again.
He's in surgery. But I'll get word to him as soon as possible. Yes? What's the name, please? Oh. That's two T's? Yes. I'll see that he gets it. Yes. Sorry, miss. The visiting hours are over.
I just wanted to know how my husband is.
Oh, I'll try and find out for you, miss. What would the name be?
Caroon. Victor Caroon.
Oh.
He's all right, isn't he?
Mrs. Caroon, I wish I could let you go up, but
we strict orders about your husband.
All I want to know is how is he? Is there any change?
Just a minute. Hello, Mabel. Alf here. Listen, how is 4B? I know all about the orders, but I only want you to think out loud. Thank you, Mabel. Thank you. He's going on the same, Mrs. Caroon. No change, but no worse.
If I could see him, just for a few minutes.
I should be shot at dawn. But don't you worry, he's in good hands.
They don't leave him alone, do they?
Oh, not for a moment. Tucker, his night nurse, is with him now, and Perkins comes on in about half an hour.
Both as good as any doctor.
Could I wait for the night nurse when he comes off duty? If only to talk to someone who's been with him. Please.
Tucker comes off in about half an hour. He usually dips out through the staff entrance. Turn left through the doors and is on the right.
Thank you.
Wait for him outside. And if they ask me, I never told you nothing.
There's only the nurse with him. His name's Tucker.
His name? You mean I got a flirt with a he nurse?
Please hurry. You've only got half an hour before the relief nurse comes on duty.
Another one in pants?
His name's Perkins.
It's money, money, money. Cash before delivery. It always gives me more confidence. Especially when my investigating is this private.
Room 4B.
4B.
Give me 15 minutes. I'll put him in the lift and send him down. Then he's all yours. I never saw you in my...
Please hurry. And he's very sick, so
don't
be
worry.
Careful.
I'll mother him like a baby.
Evening. I'm from casualty. Perkins is sick. They sent me to take over his night shift.
Fine. Well, I know I'm too honest, but you're not due for another half hour.
Who cares? Night shift is night shift. What's a half an hour here or there?
You know, you've got to have him for this.
At our rate of pay, we should get some fun out of life. What's his trouble?
He doesn't seem to know. He's the star patient. He just lies and stares. Never opens his mouth. But if he does, press that bell and quick. Well, happy nightmare.
Any special instructions?
They're all on the chart. Good night.
Night. News, my friend. Your wife is waiting for you downstairs. I'm the man who's going to get you out of here. Does that make you happy? It does? Good. Well, we don't have too much time, so up we get.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah.
What time are you off?
Ask him whether he's going to live with us.
Operating?
For about 3.5 hours at least.
You too.
Me too.
Chinese restaurants open till midnight. Take you both. Beautiful green sour pork, roast duck, fried shrimps.
You've talked us into it.
There we are. Now the jacket. That's a good boy. Can't meet the lady looking sloppy. You know, it's funny. Wives usually employ me to get them away from their husbands.
Oh, you're a sad one. Well, to each his own. Hey, steady, steady. Now, you stay here while Christy goes and gets the lift. Won't be a minute.
What do you got there?
What are you hiding? What is it?
Victor. Oh, Victor, darling. I've got the car outside. Please try and be quick. You can make it, dear. Everything's going to be all right, Victor. I'll get you the best treatment, the finest doctors. I'll get you well and strong. We'll make a new life for ourselves, away from all this. Away from him. Our life will be our own. Would you like one?
I don't think we'll find listed in forensic medicine.
It looks as though the life was drawn right out of him.
Have the body examined by your head pathologist. I'd like a report as soon as possible.
You wouldn't mind if the home office pathologist also took a little peep.
I don't care if he dunks his head into a ring.
Caroon, the other side of town. Car full of luggage.
And Caroon?
No sign of him.
Stupid idiot, trying to take the whole thing in her own hands.
Where did he go? What did she say?
She didn't say anything. Anything about him. She's in a pretty bad state
of shock.
Not
about him, then about what?
The doctor said she may even go out of her mind.
Out of her mind about what? What did she say? Come on, talk, man.
Well, when they found her, she was just sitting at the wheel of a car and moaning. Something about a hand being all gray with thorns like a cactus.
I remember there was a cactus in this room, in this pot. Can I get a direct line through this?
Yes.
Hello? Hello? Get me Scotland Yard.
Car 39. Proceed immediately to 34 Baynham Street and investigate report of prowler by resident. May be Caroon. Proceed with caution.
Car 39. Roger.
Cars 2, 1, 2. Join River Police at Hayes Wharf to search area bounded by Champagne. River Patrol 4. Join Mobile Police at Hayes Wharf to search area bordered by Tooley Street, Hayes Lane, and Strand Thames. River Patrol 4, roger, out.
This growth on the face, half plant, half... Look at this. Look what it's done. The whole tissue structure is eaten away. The bone's powder.
Well, that takes care of my supper tonight.
Briscoe, what if there is a form of life in space? Not on some planet, but just drifting.
God knows.
Not life as we know it. With intelligence, yes, but pure energy with no organic structure. Invisible.
Invisible?
Now, the rocket passed through its path. It entered the rocket. It found living specimens of our form of life. Cell organisms. Human.
Green and Reichenheim.
And Caroon, exactly. Now, if even by accident it could enter one of those structures, what a way to invade the Earth.
Now, look, sir, I'm not over-intelligent.
You saw the film, you know what happened. Only God knows where and how far that rocket traveled.
But only two of them died.
Something got into that rocket. Took the blood out of the other two, and now it's using Caroon. And it's found other forms of life. The cactus.
Good grief. You mean Caroon's
a carrier. He's now under the shell of a man being transformed. If one of these cactus plants were subject to the same mutation, there could be an affinity, a union between plant and animal.
With the ability to destroy. And possess.
And multiply. At will.
Multiply?
Yes, but to multiply, first it has to live. And like any living thing, to live, it must have food.
To do with your arm? Look, I'll just take a look. I won't hurt it, I promise.
And Briscoe to meet us there. Pa?
Now what?
I've got to go back.
But you've only just come in.
You just can't do without me, love.
I don't know why you don't move into the office.
You'd never believe I was there.
What makes you think I do now? Have your tea, at least.
I haven't got time, love.
The things you do to that poor stomach of yours. I ought to get you a picnic basket.
What I'm going on is no picnic.
What about dinner?
Cook it and keep your fingers crossed. Bye, love.
What do you think he was trying to do?
I'd like to think kill himself. The thieves will mix the normal result with death in 5 minutes.
What? What is it?
I have a pretty sick feeling it was something to speed up a change going on inside him.
But Caroon was an engineer. He didn't know anything about chemistry.
Caroon didn't know.
There's a kettle still on, and there's no sign of the chemist anywhere. What do you think he was doing here?
Well, one thing he was doing...
We're not certain.
Not certain about anything with this customer. Well?
Nobody in the street heard anything. We're all at church or in the local. He must have...
Evans, come in quick. And quiet.
Thank you.
And there's just the two of us today. We'll have our own tea party. I don't like those other girls anyway. All they do is talk about their new clothes and dolls. You don't care about those things, do you? You don't care about new clothes or anything. We're friends. Now you sit there and be a good girl while I make the tea. There's the teapot. There's the cups. And I brought the most delicious cakes and biscuits. The others never serve anything, but we do. Look, aren't they lovely? Don't be frightened. That's only the old rats that live in this old boat. Now, tea is ready. Sugar? One? Two, all right. Now you may have a cake. This one. It's filled with cherries. And anyway, I like the other one because it's full of chocolate. Oh! We thought you were rats. Won't you stay and have tea with us? We'd very much like you to stay. You look so tired. There's plenty, if that's what you're worried about. And cakes, too. Go on, Dolly. You ask him. Please, won't you have tea and cakes with us? Don't be frightened. We would like you to stay very much. And you may have the cake that has all the chocolate inside. Tell him, Dolly.
Yes. What time was this? Was it an eyewitness? I see.
Well, we're doing fine. He's been positively seen in Liverpool, Margate, Ostend and the Orkneys.
Yes? Yes. Deptford area.
What?
A kid told her mother... Yes? About 2 hours ago. Hold it, please. A kid got a doll broken by a man down by some derelict boats near Deptford.
Oh, so it had to be Caroon?
No, the mother's complaining about molesting kids. Deptford said the description could fit Caroon.
All right, well, that's why there's a police station at Deptford.
Thank you, Deptford. Keep us informed.
Mobile.
The Deptford alert on Caroon.
Yes, I know it is, so your boys can have another little drive. Oh. Cover derelict boats, warehouses and bomb shelters. All right, so do it again. Where's he getting food? That's what I'd like to know.
Now, shut up, Simba. You've had to do it. It's time to go to bed. Go on, off you go. Shh. Go on, don't stand there gaping at me. Off you go to bed.
Good night, fellas. Sleep well. Hello, Joey. You know something? Could have sworn I saw you having tea in a cafe this afternoon. Turned out to be a customer, though.
This is exactly as the keeper found them when he came on duty.
Are there others, you say?
Yes, over here. We found three more soon outside the Antelope House. Well, what was left of them?
Look.
Look at that. Complete absorption this time.
That's what I've been afraid of. Inspector, get this place closed. Get everybody out of here.
Right, as quickly and quietly as possible. No panic, no excitement.
Close the whole place up, but we already roped the arrows off.
Listen, sir, you've got to take it from us. We know what we're doing. Just tell your men to cooperate, please.
Well, I don't understand. What's happening anyway? What killed these animals?
You better say natural causes for now.
Sorry, ma'am. We're closed this morning.
Closed? But we've come all the way from Epping.
Sorry, ma'am. We're not open to the public this morning.
Will it be open this afternoon?
I wish I could tell you, sir. Sorry, folks. Zoo closed. I'm very sorry now, but we're closed.
Closed?
Sorry.
What's happened?
I'm very sorry, sir.
Here. Look at this.
It's alive.
Looks pretty horrible, doesn't it?
Quick, the sample box.
Well, what manner or shape of thing do we look for now?
You'll know it when you see it. Just send your men out with a prayer that we find it in time. It's too terrifying to think about it. In less than 12 minutes, every animal completely absorbed, except one. Gone like quicksand. But this quicksand knows what it's doing.
It's trebled its size in an hour.
Do you know what this means? This is only a fragment of the main organism. If the same thing is happening to him at the same rate of speed, if absorbing those mice to do this...
I know.
There is no living thing on Earth that stands a chance against it. How do we fight it? How do we stop it?
Hands off me, young man. Please remember that I'll come here of my own accord.
Yes, yes.
I come here to complain about something, what I saw.
Okay, Rosie, you keep saying that.
I refuse to divulge it to any common constable who has nothing else to do all day but sit on his big flat fleet. On his big fat fleet.
Now, come on, Rosie, old girl.
Don't you won't call me. I'm young enough to be your mother. So what respectable woman you want to be, I know now.
All right, constable.
But here, I come in here of my own free will. I come here of my own volition.
I'm very glad we ought to see you, Rosie. What can we do for you this time?
I wish to make a report.
Miss Rosemary Elizabeth Wrigley. What address this week?
Well, I'm temporarily visiting.
Bow Street?
With friends.
Salvation Army, the embankment. What did you see this time, Rosie?
Oh, it was terrible. Shocking.
It always is, Rosie. Just tell me what you saw.
Well, it's a bit of a thing if a young woman can't walk the streets of London without creepy crawlies being able to roam about as they please. What's the police force for if they're not to protect us from the likes of that? Come on, tell me. Tell me, what's the police force for?
Rosie.
Yes.
Rosie, just tell me what you saw. And we of the London Metropolitan Police will do all in our power to see that it doesn't occur again.
You know, my voice went so dry that I couldn't even yell for a copper. I still got this awful thirst. Makes it hard to remember. And water makes me as sick as a baby.
It better be worthwhile, Rosie. After you tell me.
I was sitting in a doorway, see, because I wasn't feeling so well. And the doctor says that too much walking's bad for my legs. It's my legs, you see.
You were sitting in a doorway?
Just for a minute or two. When suddenly I heard a kind of rustling, it was.
Rustling?
So I looked. And there at the end of the street, I saw something move. Something enormous.
What moved, Rosie?
But I couldn't make out the shape properly. I used to make out the shape of these things.
Think carefully, Rosie. Was it this something? Was it walking quickly or slowly?
Walking? It was kind of crawling up on a wall. Wasn't like any of the things that I'll see on Saturday nights.
No, Rosie, I think this time you really saw it. Get me the yard. Or cancel it. This is a priority.
Really saw it? You mean that this time it's not a it's not a gin goblin?
No, Rosie, this time it was real.
Real? It's my legs.
Hello? Scotland Yard? Yes, Inspector Lomax, please.
Lomax here. Yes? Say that again. Get the commissioner right away.
Hello? Yes. Yes? We'll be right there. Lomax. He said it climbed a brick wall 30 feet high.
Yes, no doubt at all. He was here quite recently, too. The trail ends on the wall. Let me have that case up here.
Get him his case, Sergeant. Send the car, please.
Use the car radio. I want to cordon around the entire area, evacuate all public, get information to check up every movement that's likely to take place inside this radius tonight.
Yes, sir.
Warn everyone not to touch anything unusual they may find in the streets or their gardens. Warn the children especially.
Spore-producing patches. If it had lived to complete this reproductive cycle, this room would have been a jungle of living tendrils.
How many more of these things are there around London?
I think you better find Lomax. It's not a question of how many, but where are they? If they can reproduce at this rate, another 24 hours, a few days.
Get me Scotland Yard quickly.
Yeah? Well, suppose it had reached the mice. Yes. Yes, of course.
The commissioner. They're getting him, sir.
Right. Get hold of Evans. I want him to get out an anti-panic statement. I want it broadcast, televised, and printed in all the nationals.
Yes, sir.
I want every available man in the metropolitan area. Immediate search of parks, fields, undergrounds, and subways. Yes, sir. It's the Quatermass Xperiment. I'm afraid you'll have to take it right to top level, sir. I need troops and the civil defense. Yes, sir. I'll be right up.
Quatermass.
this is all we need to start the program with a swing.
What's he talking about?
Oh, no one must touch anything unusual they find in the streets. Don't panic. Just inform the nearest police station.
They've been putting that out all day on the radio. Westminster Abbey. Yes? Standing by. Opening announcement coming up.
Okay, stand by, cameras. All right, camera one, titles are in. We'll be on you in 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. On you, camera one, where are you? All right, quick, take over camera two, on you instead. What's that? What's happened?
Looks like a body.
Kill transmission. Lime Grove? Fill in, will you? I'll get back as soon as possible. Tell presentation. Hello? What goes on here?
He fell from the scaffold. He slipped.
Dead before he fell.
Dead before he fell?
I shouldn't have got a strong stomach.
It's practically a
better go. Get the police.
Yes. Yes, get the police.
Well, will we go on with the program?
It's up to you, sir.
I'm all right. I think we'd better carry on in another part of the abbey.
Right. Pull that lot in over here, will you?
Get a blanket, something in color in lot.
Come on, quick.
It's quite a match.
Right.
The whole abbey cleared. Public, clergy, everyone. And quick.
Jesus, Hector, not so loud. There's a transmission going on.
Yeah, the transmission coming off. I want you all out of this place. Every second may count.
Remarkable thing about this
thing. Inspector, right in front of the cameras. This is going all over England.
Son, it's an emergency. Get this stopped.
Stopped? I can't stop it.
Where's your producer?
It's on the truck.
Hidden under layers of paint and aged by the dust of time.
Window. Camera three and scaffolding, hold it.
I'm Inspector Lomax. You've got to get two people out of the attic.
Please, coming on to you, camera three.
Everybody in that building may be in deadly danger.
We're on transmission. I've got to you, camera one. Turn up as high as you can. Now. What in the name of?
It must be 20 feet across.
Kill transmission. Camera one, hold that short and lock off, then everybody out. Yes, you'll just have to carry on as best you can. We can't go on here. Yes. Yes, fill in, will you?
Great of us, quick, in the truck. We'll never let Abbey have the track now.
At the Abbey, there's an emergency. You saw it? We don't know what it is.
Same pattern as the one in the lab.
Only it was 20 times the pattern of reproduction. Those nodules, if they get to spore this time, nothing will stop them. They'll break out, they'll spread by the million whenever there's air and wind.
How long before it starts reproducing again?
Based on the last cycle, 80 or 90 minutes, and then within the hours, for every one, there'll be a million more.
It's coming lower.
We've got to stop it.
We'll need a miracle to stop it now.
We'll get flamethrowers.
Parts of it might still escape. The whole of it must be killed.
Dynamite.
That would only spread it further.
Stop moving! It's barely pulsating now.
My timing was out. It's in its last dormant stage, just before it reproduces.
It's changing again.
The beginning of new spore-producing zones, doesn't it?
The way it's hanging there, wrapped around the scaffolding.
Frisco, I think we can stop it.
What now, Professor? That scaffolding inside.
I want to run cables to it, then tap the main power line. I want to send enough current into that steel to burn it up. We've got to keep pouring current to it. We have to melt it right down to the ground.
Yeah,
it's our only chance. I want every bit of current in London diverted to here.
You'll bring the city to a standstill.
If that thing spores before we kill it, you won't have any city.
I just hope you're right, that's all. I just hope you're right.
Chris!
Thank you.
Attention, everybody. Attention, everybody. There is no cause for alarm. I repeat, there is no cause for alarm. Please do not crowd. Unless you have official business in this vicinity, please disperse. Go back to your home. There is nothing to see. Go back to your home.
Stand by. Switch on. Well, this time you won. In my simple Bible way, I did a lot of praying. One world at a time is good enough for me.
Can we ease it all up now, sir? Is it all right, sir? About all this.
I've only just heard, sir. Might have been here sooner. Is there anything I can do?
Yes, Marsh. Gonna need some help.
Help, sir? What are you gonna do?
Gonna start again.